again, everyone. It's Kaz Bielan. This is Casual Conversations, a program where we talk to people very important to our world. Today, we have a very special guest. Her name is Joetta. She's a four-time Olympian. She's an author. She's an entrepreneur, a speaker, and 25 years you were in track and field. Tell me about that.
Yes. Thank you for having me on your show, Kaz. Nice seeing you again. And yes, 25 years of running track and field. I started very young, well, not really too young, but I started on the scene probably around 12 or 13, and then I retired when I was 38.
Wow. So I have a little video clip which kind of sets up your approach to track and life and everything. So let's take a look at this, and we'll talk about it afterward.
I grew up in the great city of Newark, New Jersey, and I spent most of my time between Newark, New Jersey and South Orange, New Jersey. You look at my legacy, and when I started running when I was 8 years old, I did not think about a legacy. I wanted just to run and have fun. But after a 28-year career, I think there is a legacy. And I started running middle distance and distances because my father, Dr. Joe Clark, the subject of the movie Lean On Me, wanted us to run distance because he wanted to dispel the notion that Black Americans could not run distance. At that time, only Africans were running the distance runs. So back then, if your parents had to do something, you did not talk back, you needed to wait. So I started running the distance runs.
You have to have sort of, I know, a base, you know, for life. And I know how important parents and family are to you. So that must have been, you know, tough or easy. How was that? You know, having a dad who's kind of telling you, you know, approach to life at that time.
Well, back in the early 60s, Kaz, when I was a kid, we didn't talk back to our parents. So my mother was Jetta. My father was Joe. That's how they got the name Joetta. And no one talked back. And so when they said to do something, we did it. So I don't know if it was difficult. I don't know if it was hard. I know that's what it was, and that's how we got along. So I don't look at my childhood as being difficult. I looked at it as being something that had some direction, some vision. They had hope, and so that's what they wanted to instill in us, that we use sports as a way to be better people, but also they always focus on education.
Well, I think they worked out very well. I mean, four-time Olympian. You know, people just get, once they get in there is amazing, but four time. And I think the other amazing thing is that, you know, a lot of the other family members also were in the Olympics. I mean, how did that come about as a process? You know, who decided you're all going to go for it? Or was there a competition between all of you to try to get in there? How did that work?
Well, that's a good question. And it makes it even more special because my brother and I are just 2 years apart. But my sister is 15 years younger. So I made my last Olympic team in 2000, and that was her first Olympic team. And my brother was the Olympic coach of us and his wife. So to answer your question, no, we were not thrown in to say become Olympians. Sports was used as a way to make us better people. And the irony here is that I made four teams, my sister made three teams, and it's such a big age gap. So they were able to do it with us, and then 15 years later, they did it with my sister. So that was something really special.
Well, you had it was called Team Clark, I believe, back then. And that was just amazing thing. And just want to let everybody know, you can get all the information about Joetta at joettasportsandbeyond.com. And kind of getting back to that, the last time you were in the Olympics, it was qualifying for the Olympics, I should say, right? There was a very dramatic moment. Can you tell me about that?
Yes. My last Olympic team, that picture right there kind of says it all. My brother is in the back, and then my sister-in-law is on with the Reebok outfit on. My younger sister's in the middle, and I am on the other side. So we went 1, 2, 3 in the Olympics trials that year. And that was the first time that the family had gone 1, 2, 3 and taken every spot on the Olympic team. So that was a very special moment. And it was even more special to have our parents alive to witness such an amazing accomplishment.
Well, I've seen that moment and it gives me chills. So I want to share with everybody else. So let's look into another video clip to show people exactly what that moment was like. Because, and you can talk about it a little further how you really felt at that moment, but we can tell from this clip. So let's check this out, okay?
Yes. What do you gotta do? What is it in your life that you gotta do? Not tomorrow, not next week, but now. If you look at my race from 2000, I gotta get from 8th place to 3rd place.
It's the three members of the Clark family and Meredith Bauman as they hit the home straightaway. Hazel Clark has the lead. Jeremiah Clark is second. Meredith Bauman is third. Joanna Clark digs in fourth. Top three for Sydney. It's Hazel Clark.
So what in life do you gotta do? And when you do that, you can't look back and change your mind. So when you make a decision that you're going to do something, don't change your mind in the middle. Because when you do that, it kind of deflates the gotta do. Because the gotta do is in your heart. You know you gotta do that.
That's true, you gotta do that. You know, I find that, like, you know, because I do videos and commercials and you know, I record it and there's time to edit it. So if I have other things, I kind of do that. But when a person asks me, someone's going to be ready, I tell them that exact day. That's what I got to do. It's like, I know that. I promise to them, and I'm going to deliver it.
Yes, that's your deadline. That watching that video is still such a chilling moment for me. I was, again, 38 years old. But I think the thing that resonates with me the most is that Team Clark was something that we didn't make up on our own. The people, the public, the sports enthusiasts gave us that name, and we did not know that we were going to be in the history books like we are 21 years later. Yeah. But we knew that we wanted to make the Olympic team, all three of us, and it was going to be a hard challenge, especially with me being older and my sister making the first team. But I'm just very thankful that we had the opportunity to make the team together and represent the great country over in Sydney, Australia.
Yeah, that must have been amazing. So tell me about... You became a motivational speaker. I want to talk about that next, because I think, you know, you must have these memories that are different places you've been, different things. But when you go in front of a young group of kids, let's say, you know, what are they looking from you at that point? That you, is it something you sense, or, you know, or what feedback do they give you after your speech also?
Well, thanks, Cass, for asking that question. I've been doing motivational speaking for over 25 years, actually. More like 30 years. I made my first speech after the 1988 Olympic Games at an elementary school. And I was just thrilled that someone wanted to hear me speak. And at that time, I didn't know what to say, didn't have a format. I was just happy to do an assembly program at Maple Avenue School in Newark. Fast forwarding now, what I talk about to kids specifically, K through 12, is that it's not about being an Olympian, but it's about being the champion of your life. So I give them tools and strategies to help them realize that they are champions and that they can be the champion of their lives if they implement the P's, if they have a purpose, they get prepared, they're patient, they get perturbed, and they persevere. And if they trust the adults and take everything takes time. So that's pretty much my speech for the younger people. Is that it's not about being the Olympic champion, but it's about being the champion of your life and how to go about accomplishing those feats.
Well, it's funny you mentioned the principles, because one great resource is your book that's been out there that basically, you know, encapsulates all that information into a wonderful book. And so tell me a little bit further about the P principles that you recommend.
Well, I am so happy that the book is still doing well, and I have a copy here as well. My book. So it's been out for a while, but we've changed a lot of things in it. Yeah. And basically, the book is a template for your life. At the end of each chapter, there are questions, and people fill out those questions. And then when they're done with the book, they have a template on how they're going about doing things. So a lot of corporations use the book for team leadership, team empowerment. Colleges use the book for the freshman experience. Middle schools read the book, and college students also read the book for course. And I never could have planned that. When I wrote the book, I just wrote the book because people kept saying to me, Joetta, you have so much information. give us something, give us something. So when the people ask, I delivered. So I wrote that book, and it's been around for a long time, and it's still doing very well. A lot of corporations buy the book for functions. So instead of them giving a calendar, for example, they give the audience and the employees something that they can work on. So I really want everyone to look at the book and go to the website, and they can purchase the book that way and do the work. In order for you to be the champion of your life, you have to put the work in. And so often people don't want to put the work in. They think it's very easy and they get frustrated. But if you get the book, put the work in, read the book, answer the questions, and develop that championship template for your life.
No, that's so important, because, you know, I have kids at different ages, and, you know, a lot of the young people just think everything's going to come easy to them. First job, no big deal.
Yes.
And that's not true. So I think that's a message, powerful message by example you can give to them. I mean, I think adults as well, because everybody needs that these days, especially what we've been gone through. And, you know, you find that true?
I find that to be very true, especially now with the pandemic and us pivoting to move forward and make these changes in our lives and staying healthy mentally, physically, and spiritually. So I do believe that we can get things done quickly. It doesn't work. To the victor goes the spoils. And if you're going to be victorious, you have to put the work in and be patient and work diligently to the end. And whatever that end is, it's your purpose. It's not my purpose. What is it that makes you happy? What is it that you know that you do that no one else does? And once you find that, stay true to that. As I always say, remain focused. And FOCUS is an acronym for follow one course until successful. So if you do that, it'll be fine. Look, Kath, I made 4 Olympic teams. That's not something many people made, but I tried out 6 times. So had I given up on the first time when I was in high school, I did not make the team. And if I would have given up my senior year in college, I would not be here as a 4-time Olympian and the women's team captain in 2000. So the goal here is that you stay focused. And I use my Olympic experience, my track and field experience, to launch many products, to be a successful businesswoman, and to help other people.
Wow. No, it's you're such a wonderful example to everyone of all ages, because, you know, I've done videos and things with seniors as well. And, you know, they want to be active. They want to be involved. So, you know, I'm sure they would, anyone would enjoy the book and reading it. Let's move on quickly to the next generation, your daughter, because, you know, most people assume, okay, your daughter, if there's a football player, whatever, the kids are going to do the same thing. And in this case, she did. But, you know, what did you tell her? You know, like, you know, she went out there, like you said, must have been some trials, tribulations beginning. You know, if she said she doesn't want to do it or whatever, what did you tell her?
I think that what I told her specifically was that follow your heart. And she did everything to escape track and field. She was an equestrian. She did ice skating. She played basketball and soccer. But God had it come back to track and field and to something that she really enjoys doing now. And she is the best when she was in high school in the country at her respective event, which was the 200 and 400. And now that she's in college, she's the SEC champion. She's runner up at the NCAAs. And at 18, she qualified for her first Olympic trials. She did not make the team this year, but I think that this is an awakening experience for her. And I do believe that as we move forward, you will see a lot more of Talitha Diggs, who is a sophomore now. This is 2021, so she's going into a sophomore year at the University of Florida.
Wow. That's amazing. Good luck to her and everything. I'm sure she'll do a wonderful job. Got a great example in a mother and a family as well.
I know that she will, and I have to have a mommy moment here, because not only is she academically sound, athletically sound, she's academically sound as well with the 4.0. She's an NCAA Academic All-American, SEC Academic All-American. So in our family, as my father and mother, which are her grandparents, they really wanted us to do well athletically and academically. And the legacy is still following along with my daughter.
Yeah, the scholar-athlete combination is so important, especially these days. You got to keep on track, in a sense, you know, in life.
No question. No pun included, but I keep on track.
Right, exactly. You know, but it fits in his case, you know. So let's move on and talk about, I guess, other ventures that you're involved with. I know, athlete is good. You got the presenter, but you might need sometimes another piece of the package just so how you look and how you, you know, smell, how you, everything about yourself. When you present yourself, you know, for the first time, people meet you. Yeah. That first impression is great. So I know there's a new product line. So instead of you talking about it right now, let's look at this video, really cool video about a new product line that you're involved with. So let's check this out, okay?
Yes. My name is Joetta Clark, and my fragrance is Joetta. I am so happy to tell you about Joetta because it is a part of me. As a four-time Olympian, people often ask me, what can I give to them? I was known as an athlete. Then I became an author. Then a businesswoman. So I got to a point where I said, well, what else can I do that will empower women and to make them feel good? I see different fragrances out there, but I didn't see what I wanted. So that vision a couple of years ago has now become a reality. I did a lot of testing, and then we just toyed around, and we wanted to make it a natural product. And finally came up with something that I liked that was light, that was refreshing, and I think that they will love it. This is a natural oil perfume that has wonderful benefits for the skin. The bottle is super compact, it's small, it's easy to slip into your purse, and you carry it with you. Joetta, you can take it with you for all occasions. And we're different things on different days. Sometimes I'm sophisticated, sassy, intellectual, relaxed. Whatever it is, you take that with you and you apply it to yourself. Literally apply it to yourself. You are a champion of your life, so be a champion of your body, of your skin. So now I'm giving them a little bit of Joetta, that you feel empowered, emboldened, successful. Joetta, for the champion in you.
There you go, for the champion in you.
Thank you.
I like that. Where did you do that? That's a lot of glamour shots there, looking very nice.
Yeah, that was actually done at a friend's office right off of 440 in Jersey City. So over that way. So that's where I shot that. And that video, I enjoyed shooting it, but I enjoyed making the product. When I did a lot of my women empowerment events, they always wanted to have something. Oh, I wish I could be like you. And I said, well, you can't be like me, but you could have a piece of me, a part of me.
Yeah.
So that's why I started with the first thing, which was the oil perfume, which was an all natural mm-hmm. piece. And a friend and I sat down and we talked about what we would put in here, the mango, the cucumbers, all of those natural mm-hmm. products. And we just kept testing and testing and finally came up with the product that I liked. And then we went to the next step. We had the body butter, which is the lotion for when you get out of the shower, you put that on during the day. It smells good. It keeps your skin soft. And then, of course, while you're in the shower, you have to have the body scrub, which is Joetta's body polish, Mango Queen, for the queen, the queen and all of you. So you can go to the website, which Kaz has shown you over and over
again.
Just the product from there, and let us know what you think about it.
No, that's amazing. So is that only for ladies? You got a new line coming out for the gentlemen?
Well, actually, the scrub and the perfume, men wear that. And I was surprised. The body scrub, it exfoliates. And the smell of the scrub basically it leaves when you dry off and put your other lotions on. So the men feel fine with that. But the perfume, a lot of men wear the perfume and they say they like it. Plus, it attracts other women, they say. So when they have it on, you ask them what they're wearing, and they say, Joetta, and it starts a conversation. So it's something for everybody, men and women alike, and people have different reasons for wearing it. But the one thing I can tell you, if you do wear it, you'll smell fresh, you'll smell good, and you will work on that champion that's in you. That's what it's all about, trying to have people get to that championship mentality. And we go about it different ways. It could be the book. It could be our podcast. It could be our perfume. There are many ways for us to get to that championship level and help you realize that you have that in you. And whatever it takes for me to get that out, I will definitely try my best to help you.
Well, one of my daughters in high school, she did the 5K. She made varsity.
Okay.
And then in college, she kind of went away from it. And now after college, she's suddenly back into it, running every single morning. So some kind of bug got reignited in there. And, you know, I think that's amazing. Very happy for her. She's also into nutrition as well. And, you know, Joy Time Fitness, is that something that could help in that?
Yeah, thanks for asking. Joy Time Fitness is a product that I came up with. And it's a fitness line that we came up with. Not the product, it's a fitness line that we came up with. And it's a fitness app, which will be coming out in September. So if you go to the website below, you'll find out more about the Joe Time Fitness. And myself and my partner, we work really hard, and he does a great job putting information together so we can have an amazing product. So often when you partner with somebody, you don't know what's going to happen. Yeah. But the energy and the synergies of the Joe Time Fitness, when we got together, it just worked. And so we put our two names together, and we came up with Joe Time Fitness, because it's Joette and Tyrone, and it comes together with that. But this product is revolutionary. It only takes 20 minutes, and at Joe Time Fitness, we meet you where you are. So if you are a beginner, if you're advanced, or if you're intermediate, we meet you where you are, and we work with us. And so that there are different apps that you can click on, different exercises, so it'd be fun. And in September, Kaz, we have the Joe Time Fitness Challenge, and for 28 days, we're going to do pre and post results, and we're going to help you get through the first month of the rest of your life being healthy. So it's going to be a very exciting challenge, and we ask everybody to go to the website starting in August so you can start getting the tools that you need, so such as the Joe Time Journal and some other things that we ask you to get to be part of the Joe Time Fitness Challenge.
Well, looks like you're trying to get me to sign up for it, because you said we have it for you. So.
Yes, absolutely, for you.
I know it's everyone else out there.
Yes, absolutely. You know, we always, in track and field, we say you have to be in it to win it. So if you're not in with us on the Joe Time Fitness, you're not going to win. And the win, again, is not the gold medal from the Olympics, but it's the gold medal of your life. What are you going to do to get the gold medal of your life? And nice. Joe Time Fitness is here to help you do that.
Yeah. Hey, speaking of Olympics, as we're recording this, in a couple of days, the 2021 track and field events will start at the Olympics. What are your personal feelings? I know you're not there, but just the way that things are being, the conditions that they're being under right now with no fans, what are your personal feelings about that?
Yes. Well, I think going into this year specifically, the Olympics were going to be challenging and daunting. So I think that anyone that made the Olympic team, the expectations of prior Olympic Games were not on this one. I'm just very fortunate and blessed that I made Olympic teams that had people in the stands. There's always been something going on. In Atlanta, there was a bombing. In Seoul, Korea, there was the attack possibly on the village. It's always something. But I think that when you use sports as a way to galvanize the troops and the countries, if you will, to come together as best you can. So I think under the circumstances, they're doing the best they can. It's not going to be the Olympics that they've seen in the past or wanted to be part of, but they're there. And complaining right now is not going to do anything, because you're on a big stage. And so what you have to do is mentally adapt for the new situation and be able to bring your best for your competition. And complaining isn't going to help. And having that all of that pressure about COVID and everything, that's not going to work either. You're over there, know what you were going into. So let's focus and do the best you can under the circumstances. And when you leave there, you can't have any excuses. We believe in eliminating excuses. So if you're going to go over there with an excuse as to why you're not going to perform, you'd be better off staying home. That would be my take on that.
Yeah, you got to show, right?
Yeah, when champions show up, they show out. And everyone's not going to get the gold medal, silver, or bronze. That's not everyone's goal. Yeah. Some people are just happy to be there. I think the Olympics are putting so many different events in, so you have more people attending with all the different type of events that they're adding. But I just think that the Olympic Games is the height for athletes. And the professional athletes in tennis and basketball, they wanted to be part of it. So they're even, and golfers are at the Olympic Games. And I just think that even though the Olympic spirit isn't tainted, I would think the atmosphere is, let's face it, it's not the same. But I think the Olympic spirit, go Team USA, that is still something that's really big. And we look forward to watching them. And I will watch them like I always do, and just analyze and see what's going on and see how the performances are going. And I know a lot of people in track and field and some of the other sports too. So I will watch them, see how they're doing. But there's nothing that can compare to being at the Olympics with people in the stands. Yeah. So to have that happen is challenging, but it's real. And you knew that before you went there. So focus on what the goal is at task, which is to do your best.
Go USA, win-win, right?
Absolutely. Discover that champion.
That's right. So any final very, key takeaways that you want people to remember about yourself and about your approach to life?
Well, I think about myself is that I'm someone that cares. There's someone that wants to make a difference, not only in my life, but in the lives of others. I think that at this point in my life, it's important for me to give back. And that's why I have the foundation, the Joetta Clark Diggs Sports Foundation, that's been around for over 21 years. Yeah. And my motivational speaking, I talk about diversity, inclusion. I talk about team leadership. We have the Joetime Fitness app coming out and my Be Extraordinary podcast. The Be Extraordinary podcast is all about making people realize how great that they are. And anything that I do and anybody that I partner with, they're great as well. And so what we're trying to do is help you realize that and be consistent at that. So what I want you to take away from me is that I care and that I work diligently getting sponsors to help me put these the different shows into action and so that they could be successful and that they can always reach out to me at the website. They can reach me at my at Twitter at Joetta Olympian and Instagram at Joetta Olympian, and that I'm accessible, meaning that I respond to questions. I'm one of those people that even though people look at me as a celebrity, you're only a celebrity if you have fans. And so it's my job to make sure that my fans can touch, see, feel me in some way. So if it's not with the book, if it's not with the perfumes, if it's not with the shows, they can email me and I will respond. Yeah.
No, she does respond, folks, because I reached out to Joetta, a month or so ago, and she did respond. She said she's kind of doing her crazy things, but she will get back to me. And yes, we did arrange this interview, and I'm so happy that we got to speak to you. Your books, your podcast, everything is so motivational, and everyone can take something from that to improve their lives, improve their health and everything. So final big question here is, how did you enjoy this interview? Was it casual for you enough?
Yes, Cass, it was a casual interview, but very productive and very informative. And I think that we met many years ago when I was working with the seniors in Hillsboro, New Jersey. Yeah. And I think that to watch you still develop and navigate through everything is refreshing. So often people don't know how to recreate, reinvent themselves to be relevant in these times. So I applaud you for being relevant and doing this casual conversation and having me as a guest on your show.
Oh, thank you very much. As usual, folks, you can reach out to Joetta, JoettaSportsAndBeyond.com for everything you need to know about Joetta. And you'll learn so much. Go to YouTube channel. All the links we'll have below that she mentioned, Twitter, Instagram, everything else. And Joetta, have great conversations with everybody else you want. I give you full permission and have a great day. All right. Thank you very much again.
Thank you for having me.